Hello, and welcome to the Stress Testing with Dynamic Variables video. In this video, we're going to discuss how to create a web application stress test with dynamic variables. Let's say we need to add dynamic variables to the script to check if any type of user configuration can successfully log in and if the service will handle the traffic. To achieve this, we will convert the login parameters in the script to context parameters. In the script, I need to find the lines where I have typed in the username and password while logging in. Then I click Type Text Parameter, and this opens a working pane for the parameter with the string value. I click the Menu button and convert to Text Parameters. This opens a Settings window. If you change a parameter to Context, it is best practices to change its default name to a more meaningful one to distinguish it among others in the future. After saving, we can see our parameter value has been changed to Context. Next, we will do the same for the password parameter. When created, your parameters can be found under the corresponding tab of the script area. From here, you can edit parameters, values, and settings. Once we have changed our script, we need to save it. It is always recommended to play back a script to be sure there are no errors detected in it. Then we need to save the task for the stress test. On this test scenario page, the section with dynamic variable settings appears because we have added context parameters to the script. From here, I need to attach a spreadsheet with dynamic variables list to the test scenario. Actually, you can create a spreadsheet manually in a CSV file and upload it, but we will use a pre-configured template by downloading it. You can see that the template has a simple structure. We have the columns with the parameter names in the headers. When adding data to the file, note the number of rows in the columns must be less or equal to the maximum number of virtual users used for the test. Also, you can use identical or unique values for dynamic variables. To fill the template with data, I paste the values to these columns. The next thing we will do is save and upload the file to the scenario. From here, you can delete or download your file at any time to modify it. Now we can proceed to configure the test and run it to ensure that our web app can handle logging in by multiple users. If you still have any questions, please feel free to contact your sales representative, our technical support team, or check our wiki page for more detailed information. Thank you for watching and happy testing.